Good evening. This is Antony Santosh, Assistant Professor of Chemistry in St. Joseph College of Arts and Science. I am handling physical chemistry. Let us discuss one topic in physical chemistry.
In this video, we are going to discuss about liquid crystals. In this liquid crystal, we will be discussing about introduction, classification, and applications. In the liquid crystals topic, why it gets this name? Liquid crystals, we may be knowing that there are three states of matter. One is solid, another one is liquid, another one is gaseous state. This liquid crystals is termed in some places as the fourth state of matter, but where it gets its name, it is because of the name of mesomorphic state, in which we have got the name as intermediate form. Mesomorphic means intermediate form in the language of Greek. When we heat the solid material of this liquid, any one of the liquid crystal, it transforms into a turbid liquid at one particular temperature, and when we heat it again, it transforms to a clear liquid at another temperature. So the first transition point is the appearance of the liquid crystal, and another transformation happens at the melting point. So it undergone two different phase transformation or phase transition. So the turbid liquid is the liquid crystal, and the clear liquid is the true liquid, and that will happen at higher temperature. These liquid crystals are usually, these materials are usually long chain organic materials with terminals as OR, COOR like groups, or in between they will be having C double bond C, N double bond NO, C double bond N like groups. This is the one type of indication of that particular material may be possessing this liquid crystal nature. Liquid crystals are a state of matter which has properties between those of conventional liquids and those of solid crystals. For example, a liquid crystal may flow like a liquid, but its molecule may be oriented in a crystal-like way. So their arrangement of their morphology shows they are crystal-like material, but they flow like liquid. So both the properties of liquid and solid, so they are termed as liquid crystal. And this kind of liquid crystal materials was first discovered in the year 1888, and the cholesteryl benzoate is the first material which is discovered, which has the molecular formula of C6H5C20COOC27H45, and it has the transition temperature of 145 and the melting temperature of 178 degrees Celsius. And in the year 1991, the French physicist who is you are seeing now, P.G. de Gennes, the Nobel Prize is given to him for his contributions to the physics of liquid crystals and polymers. So by his contribution only, and the liquid crystal has its is invented. Okay. Liquid crystals are, there are so many materials. We have the examples now. Anisole design, the first material. CH3OC6CH4CHNNCHC6H4OCH3. It has the transition point of 165 degrees Celsius and melting point of 180 degrees Celsius. Next, second one, para azoxy anisole. CH3OC6H4NON, again C6H4OCH3. Its transition point is 116 degrees Celsius and its melting point will be 135 degrees Celsius. Next, para azoxy phenol, C2H5OC6H4NONC6H4OC2H5. And its transition point is 137 degrees Celsius. Its melting point is 167 degrees Celsius. Next, diethyl benzidine, C2H5NH6H4C6H4NHC2H5. And its transition point, the turbid appearance of turbid liquid is 115 degrees Celsius. And melting point is 120 degrees Celsius. And we have mercury containing mercury containing liquid crystals, and another one, paramethoxycinnamic acid, which are having their temperatures as like this, 170 and 170 and 186, like that. Okay, the liquid crystals may be classified like this. This appearance, this diagram of this one is nematic liquid crystals, and this type of arrangement of liquid crystals will be named as smectic liquid crystal. And another one is cholesteric liquid crystals, this one, cholesteric liquid crystal. And they will be, when we go for there are so many material, so many methods to identify, to photograph, to take some kind of characterization. These are all different kinds of characterizations made by microscope like materials, XRD, and XRD means X-ray diffraction method. And likewise, we have some spectroscopic method which we will be discussing in higher classes. These are all the three materials appearance, and the first one shows the rod like material, and second one shows bent like material, and the third one is a disc like material. All of them are showing thermotropic, they are, all of them are called thermotropic liquid crystals. And we will be understood what is nematic, smectic, cholesteric when we go for the explanation. So this is the crystal one, this is the crystal, and when we heat the crystal, we will be getting the liquid crystal. This is the turbid liquid, this is the turbid liquid appearance. When we heat the crystal material, that transforms into liquid crystal, turbid liquid. When we heat it again, this liquid crystal transforms into liquid. Okay, now the same kind of reversible process also available. If we cool from higher temperature, if we cool the liquid, then first there will be appearance of liquid crystal at the same temperature, when it appears liquid crystal. And when we cool it again, it transforms into crystal, that is solid one. So like this we will get. So the forward reaction and forward phase transformation and reversed phase transformation, both of them are available. One is the solid material transforms into liquid crystal at first, that is the turbid liquid, and transforms into the liquid. And when we cool the content from the higher temperature, it reversed into liquid crystal first and crystal again. Okay, so here it is shown the liquid crystal may be a nematic, may be having a nematic arrangement or smectic arrangement or columnar, that is disc shaped arrangement is possible.